So here's the latest war on other fronts. We showed you guys already a couple of games of X-Wing. This is the next power level up, 50-point games between Kenny and Juice. We got some new mechanics today here. What do you guys notice different on these cards?
Yeah, so obviously there's quite a few. Like moving to the 50-point level and getting my favorite ship, the Falcon, is huge. Also, it's going to be kind of clutch for Kenny because I know how much with those extra card tokens, being able to be stealth, that means he's going to have four evade or four things to...
Yeah, I noticed that in the first game I played that moving X-Wings or moving up against X-Wings seemed I had a natural of maneuverability advantage. And then being able to evade is something they didn't have. It was so clutch, and it eventually led to my victory, just being able to like dodge everything they did. And I am really interested in this pattern, this being able to still be really maneuverable and just juke everything off. So my limited grasp of this game tells me this is good.
Yep, these the interceptors now have extra agility, so you'll be able to get some extra dice, and we put some upgrades on there. The first one, of course, is a stealth device, which gives you an extra agility, and then you got auto thrusters, which lets you turn some of your blanks into evades, which you guys like so much.
So my baller is really hard to kill.
Yes.
My Royal Guard side.
Yeah, he can be a little rough to kill, and he also lets you get additional damage as well, and then you just got a normal interceptor here. And then we got an A-Wing with a stealth device as well. Mm. And this isn't the Millennium Falcon, but it's a Millennium Falcon, and it definitely has the title on it.
What is it called, though? What kind of ship is it? Outer Ring Smuggler?
Yep, with the title, so it's going to get evade, and also has that boost mechanic, which we're going to see today because all these ships have boost on it. So let's get right to it.
So it's time to set up the battlefield. So now we have our the comets and debris that we're gonna throw out here. So we are tied on points. So instead of rolling off or anything else, the Imperial is always up first.
From what I understand, I can't place them inside of 2x2.
Yep, there's two range from each board edge that you can place these.
So it can never be
within the two mark.
All right. So my goal is, so I can see that's kind of a cagey tactic. I've never played with these. I want one right in. I want this big old guy right in the middle.
The biggest one right dead center.
Yep.
All right, if you will help me out, I am going to put it on the two range there and the other side.
So you're going the minimum right here?
Yep.
Possible?
Yep, I want to try to keep them. My Millennium Falcon is kind of big, so I want to keep these things out of my way.
Now, what's the closest comet can be next to another comet?
Range one.
So I can go one. I don't know anything about this, but I do know when I play 40K, I like doing this.
Yep. And I will put one, two range up on my own. Two range over. Okay. And you get the last one.
Not quite sure now what I want to do, but I think I'm just going to keep doing with what I set out to do and build kind of like a little barricade here to have a little bit of fun within a midfield. I've never played with this mechanic, and I look forward to crashing it all.
Deployment it is.
I've been told that I have to deploy first since we have a tie on pilot skill and on Imperial. You told me I have to deploy within one, but I have a question on angle. Like, do I always have to face forward, or can I deploy within one, like, looking sideways or anything like that?
No, it has to be facing forward.
So this is a game of aiming forwards. So since I built a rock barrier over here, I kind of want to, you know, hit a flank, I think, like, just playing some basic tactics in my mind, and I want to, you know, potentially maybe utilize it like as best I can, because I know you can, you know, get the cut any way you want, but I want to have it and I want to use it.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to ink this little guy way into Widow Corner. I am now going to put the Falcon. Just want to make sure
that we know you should be able to fit between asteroids because your base isn't it. Right?
Yep.
So I see, like, I never really thought about that, having to line things up, because there's no pre-measuring in this game, so you want to make sure you're exactly in position. I can see that.
Yeah, and I am under a range, or I'm my base is under a range one.
Oh, so just so you should be able to fit it comfortably if you line it up, right?
Yep.
Heard that. So I guess now that we finished out pilot skill one, we get to, I now get to place my last guy. And I think that I will do something like this.
Turn one begins. We're both at pilot ones. You're up first.
So in the pilot one phase, I'm required to move first.
Yep.
So I have a move forward three.
Move forward straight three. There you go.
And I believe something I might have been doing wrong earlier. It's a front to back, right? Yep. Something I'm not used to because of 40K. That's literally cheating. And obviously I get the performance action here. So of course, the classic evade.
Evade?
Or actually, I have no idea of knowing how fast your ship is going to go, and you have an affinity firing arc. So I've never played beyond this point, so I even though I want a barrel roll right now, I'm just going to evade.
There you go. Falcon is up, so obviously in standard Mego, I'm going up four. Alright. Then I am going to hit up a
barrel
boost.
Oh, is that what a boost is? You get to go another inch for free.
Another inch for free.
More than an inch. Because the size of your ship is beast mode.
So basically what I wanted to do there
is force me to turn left or right or turn left.
Well, because I just wanted to make sure that I was going to fit in this area. Well, my boost would allow me to do that, and if I couldn't perform that action, I wouldn't take any modifiers right there. So basically, I got to find out if I was going to fit before my next move and running into those comets. So in my next phase, I could do something different. So then over here, this little dude is going to be hauling arse. And on top of it, he is also
going to perform. Oh, no, he's boosting.
Form a boost.
Oh, that's so cool. Why don't my guys boost? So, pilot skill, not one. Five. Going straight ahead with my pimp. My uber pimp. And he is one of they, because I definitely know I'm in the fire dark of Millennium. Falcon wannabe.
Space-time continuum. 2015. Get a laser so we don't sit here and touch models. This is where we're at.
So, yeah, Juice made a great point, because like, we are touching models. I mean, slightly inaccurate, and the width of that plastic is bigger. So trying to line that laser up right on it, and it looks like it... I'm not sure anymore, actually.
Yeah, I mean, I have to think, with further review, that is out.
I'm going to say with the laser, because the width...
Of the stick is longer, well, is wider than what the line is.
Yeah, I'm saying that I'm actually out of review. Further review says I'm out of the arc. Because this laser seems to be exactly the same width. So get yourself a laser, ladies and gentlemen.
Yep, we just proved it.
My pilot skill one looks like he's going to try to hit that Falcon. There's no doubt that I'm in the fire arc. So it looks like I'm not in the two. I'm in the full distance of a three. My little tire scepter has a three pew-pew symbol. So I think that means I get to roll three dice.
It does.
And two pews, as it were.
Ooh. I get three defend.
Ugh. Two focus, what does that mean?
That means I take three shields away.
Or two
shoot shields away. Good shooting. Now, my return.
I feel like the Falcon's about to shoot me back.
Coming back at you. One.
So.
And you get four.
But with an evade token, doesn't that mean I automatically have enough to block that?
No, not if you roll all...
Isn't this always one more evade than your roll?
Okay.
So, like, I'll roll it. I'll roll 1 billion evades. And it's basically functionally four evades because I have this token, right? It's always a free one. But I didn't have to burn it right now because I did successfully evade it.
Gotcha. All right, so this is the end of the turn. We remove tokens, and I also had to remove my stealth device from my Millennium Falcon because I failed to evade.
Back to it. Pilot skill one.
Pilot skill one.
I'm going for a dicey maneuver. Hard right turn.
Hard right two.
Hard right two. Something like right here, and this is definitely going to be, I do have to be careful because I know you can fly right by me if you fly fast enough to clear me. So I'm wondering if I should barrel roll now to just extend it to be here to make it more difficult for you. But if I do that, you're definitely going to open up on me. But I do have the stealth device, which is sort of like having to evade. So I think I'm going to chance it and do a barrel roll, popping myself up over here.
Barrel roll one.
Because I don't want you to clear me. And I believe Rob walked me through it. Is this correct?
Yep, sure is.
Right there.
So starting here, I've got a 3 hard right. That will then turn into a boost straight forward. Oh, excuse me, angle.
A little soft one.
There you go.
Not bad.
And for the one that everybody's been waiting for, I am actually going straight forward two.
Oh, I misplayed it.
Straight forward
no,
two.
No, he's not. I wanted him to, I thought he was going to try to blow by me because he has that 360 firing arc. Literally, my barrel rolls why he didn't crash into me.
Yep.
So I totally took a gamble. That's what happens.
So, and Kenny, you have the pilot with the best skill there. His movements.
He's doing a K turn on a 3.
On a 3K.
So, is it a straight line
straight
three?
3?
So, walk me through this, guys. Is that straight ahead like this?
Yep.
And then
and
a
then
flip?
Flip.
Like so?
Yep.
And he. Since the Falcon has got the super range on here, I assume you're going to focus fire here.
Mm-hmm. And just to put in, I did mean to.
You're actually stressed because you K-turn.
So I don't even get to do a.
You don't get to perform.
I don't even get an action.
Focused.
So,
yeah,
but you get to shoot.
I think I have something like an explanation point to represent that.
Mm-hmm.
Stressed. Got it. Thank you.
Top of the phase. We're checking again, and man, without this laser, I think it would be so tough. But again, it proves the fact that I'm safe.
So now we're to the pilot skill 1 phase, and I think I get the break ties.
You do?
So I guess the only thing I can try to shoot is your A-wing, if possible.
Yep.
Just barely at a 3, which means I have 3 pew-pew dice to send your way. 2 pews.
All right, and I get 4 to try to stop it. And I stop it.
Stop it.
So I'm going to go right into mine. This is literally point blank.
That's maximum, right?
Maximum, so I get an extra dice. And I am focused, so we'll see if I have to use it. Oh!
Not bad. So right out the gate, I have 3 evades. My stealth device gives me a 4 evade.
Yep.
So I need to somehow turn... I need to make some...
Yep, you gotta
see
some squiggly lines.
I only have 3 armor pieces,
yep.
So this literally kills me if I don't make some. I only make 1.
And you also, as the Millennium Falcon later, lose your
No stealth and 1 whole point left.
Oh, man. So I took stealth away, but I am... We've already predetermined that I am at range 3 on him. I only get 2 attack dice.
I did
convert 1.
So because at the maximum range, I get an extra dice?
Yep. So you would have had 5. Now you've got 4.
Got triple evaded.
Man, how nice would have
that
been last time?
Amazing. So busters get to go first?
Wounded busters get to go first.
Looks like a straight 2. And of course... Going to evade.
I will.
Can't be playing no games.
Follow right behind you with this guy with a straight 2 as well. And this guy is going to focus. Actually, he will target lock. And then now the Falcon. SoftBank left.
Call it a Yost.
A Yost.
Is that a Silent J?
Oh.
Are we lined up?
Nope. I still got to come some more. Oh, flawless.
Flawless.
It doesn't get any closer than that. And then what we are going to do here is this will turn into a focus.
Hardcore shit. Hardcore maneuvers. Coming in for a soft two. Hopefully I'm lined up right there. And I think I'm going to throw an evade token on me because I do have some bonuses that allow me to spend evade tokens to do more stuff. So we'll see what I can do. I guess we're in the, what is it called?
The pew phase.
Pew phase. And what is it, higher, well.
Yep, everything else is kind of lower, but now you want to, the more skilled you are, the better you shoot.
So obviously I'm trying to shoot the Falcon.
There's no discrepancy here if we are in the firing arc or not.
Yep. So I'm in the two range. It looks just barely. So I have three pews. And see what I get. Right now I get one hit. And I'm allowed to spend my evade token right now to turn one of these into a hit. So I'm just going to ballsy do it. Evade token's gone. Two hits.
So, I have one green thing. Got it. No more shields. I take both of them.
So my wing in a prayer shape looks like he's in range hotness mode. So I believe that means I get to add an extra attack dice. So my three pews turn into four pews, trying to go after your A-wing. I'll take a critical and two pews.
Ooh, that is clutch. I get three plus my stealth device, so let's see what I can cancel out. I cancel out one, and that guy wasn't focused.
So do you get to pick if it's a critical or a
no? Yeah, you take normals first, and then have to leave the criticals for later. So, but I do have two shields, so that will eliminate both of my shields. We are doing up on the prototype pilot A-wing up first. I've got three because I'm within the range one. And I get to reroll these because he is
target locked.
Target locked.
So clutch. Three crits?
Two crits. Three crits, yes. That's
three crits. So I have three evade. And an evade token. So literally, I need two squigglies at least in order to get out of this. Nope. That will probably destroy me.
That's it. All right. So luckily enough, the Falcon, we just threw down the laser light again. And luckily enough, I am in, he is in my firing arc. It's a joke because my firing arc is 360. So we've already determined we're at range two. I get two dice. I'm literally going to use my focus to turn that to a hit.
Okay, so what I have here is stealth of the shields plus three evade. And I get to turn any one of my blanks if I wanted to, because it's one of my abilities, the auto flexors, into an evade if I needed to. So that's what would have been four evades if I needed it to be.
I'm glad I didn't have four hits, because that would have been frustrating. Alright, so top of the movement phase, and I get to go first because there's one less ship on the ground. So we will do this first. We are going to do a three flip K-turn.
K-turn, and this is clutch.
No, this is tight.
Classic Juice, though. He's made nothing but incredibly tight moves, and he has eyeballed these things with pure precision the whole game.
Is it going to fit? Is it going to fit?
Yo, literally, with like a quarter inch to spare.
Tight. That's how we like it. And then I'm going to do a three soft right.
Got you, player.
Thank you, dog. Followed by, so I have to take a stress token here on the Falcon. And then what I will do here is take a evade.
try to get blown up.
Nope. Out of shields everywhere.
So, going forward, gotta keep pimps in the firing arc. Or nothing's gonna happen. And of course, I gotta stay hot with these evade tokens because I get to flip those over if I need them. Back to the pew pew phase. I got three of the pew pews shooting at the Falcon. Two hits, no crits.
All right, I get one dice. Nothing, so I take two. I have four left. Man, he has been doing some damage these last two shooting phases. So we're gonna do the prototype pilot first. Here, I get two plus one for being so close range. One.
So right now I have three evade, and I'm a stealth shield, so I have four evade. And so I'm gonna have to use my evade token, but is this constitute a fail to lose my shields? So I've not failed to evade, but I do use my evade token to get out of that.
Locking this up. See what he can do. No other bonuses, just what I roll. A hit and a crit.
Oh, you're on fire. So I have three evade and my stealth token. I'm gonna need to get two squigglies here. I didn't get any last time. One squiggly, so I take a crit. So I'm taking a hole point, flip it. All players must ignore your pilot ability and all your upgrade cards. Well, I'm just gonna throw these upgrade cards away. And what's my pilot ability that I'm also ignoring? The six?
Elite pilot skill, it looks like. That's the symbol there. So like if you had all players gain... Oh, okay, so you keep your modification cards. You just, if you had an elite pilot skill down here...
No, it says upgrade cards.
Yeah.
So those are
all gone. Players must ignore your pilot ability and all of your... No, this is a specific kind of upgrade
card. So this symbol, that little symbol means
yep.
something?
Yeah.
So show me the symbols on here that would correspond with.
These actually don't have symbols. They're later on past this mechanic. So this is called a modification. Every ship can have one. And this is a title, and every ship can have one as well. And you lost the stealth generator. That was another modification. And you could take two because you took the title.
So what does this actually do to me?
This one, if you had, this is called an elite pilot skill upgrade card. So stuff like push the limit or determination, there's a whole slew of them. It's basically to upgrade the actual pilots itself. Now, your pilot ability is actually this also. So you can not do this.
So this little window, which is one of my coolest things where I can spend my evade token to get another hit,
mm-hmm.
that is ignored. That yep. is how it affects me.
That so is I, how it affects you. So it could have been worse.
Okay. So I take a whole point. This window is dead to me now.
Yep.
I'll take it. All right. So we are going to go Falcon first. Straight ahead one to get rid of that stress.
Classy. Juice with the precision movements as usual.
Yep. And then we are also going to go in and do a... And I'm just going to go all out for it. I'm going to go target.
Target lock?
Target lock.
It's time to finish this?
Yep. We're going to see what happens. Okay. Then I'm going to go a hard.
Just to base me?
Yep.
Sorry. Is it like, does that end up being like, do we go flush? Or do we just hit, stop when you hit?
Normally what you do is you just kind of use the rear guides to kind of guide it along the movement.
And you stop.
Template until, yeah.
Really, that's what it looks like.
But that's probably what it would look like, yeah.
Got it.
And then now since I've hit him, I can't perform any other actions?
You cannot perform actions, but you could shoot at other ships if they were in your firing arc.
Gotcha.
Just not me. Am I allowed to shoot at other ships?
You are.
So I can shoot the Falcon. It's
not him.
I can shoot the Falcon, though.
You sure can.
Hell yeah. So, am I allowed to move, though?
You are.
So, unfortunately, I'm going to probably drag myself right out of Falcon range with a straight two. It's just literally the slowest I'm allowed to move. And, of course, I will slap an evade token on, live to fight another day if possible.
Looks like you're actually in his arc.
Oh my god, I think you're right.
Yeah.
That's the one time. This is where I really would have loved to have my attacker, my pilot skill, to be able to flip to be able to waste my evade to flip over a couple more hits, because I want to one-shot this guy right now. But it's unrealistic. So let's see. Only literally one hit.
Ah, take another one.
So, I mean, I'm doing the work with this little TIE fighter.
And then we just roll right into mine. I get three.
Three pews.
Target lock.
Get that reroll.
Clutch. Convert it to a crit.
Clutch. So I have no stealth anymore. So I literally have been beaten down by Juice's epic trip pews.
Every time.
So I need to get an epic squiggly right here. Good game, brother.
Well, that's about it for this one, folks. Hopefully you enjoyed the latest installment of our Wars on Other Fronts. That was a 50-point game of X-Wing. We have lots more to cover, so definitely make sure you check out all of these exciting X-Wing webcasts. You know, we're going to get out of the tutorial mode soon and get into some really exciting bigger point games for some of the new ships and some of the new metas. There's another faction out there we haven't even touched yet. So it's going to be exciting times, but we want to get you guys up to speed with how the game works first. That being said, head on over to thelongwar.net. It's the home of the Battle Reports and our new webcast and podcast as well. So we got a lot going on over there. For exclusive content and early access videos, become a veteran of the Long War today.